earlier we had an executive session, and we do have some items that we discussed in executive session that require a public vote. So at this time, Mr. Britt has a couple motions to make.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Got two items I'd like to address. In executive session, council discussed a confidential economic development matter relating to the proposed location of a business within the county and provision of services encouraging the location of that business. I move to authorize the county administrator and staff to proceed on behalf of the county with any negotiations relating to that matter, and for the county administrator to execute any necessary agreements or other documents for that matter on behalf of the county within the limits discussed in the executive session.
Second.
Have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? Vote affirmative. It passes.
Thank you. Next item, I move to authorize the county administrator to execute all documents necessary to accept the donation of the Lawson's Fort Creek property within the limits discussed in executive session.
Have a motion.
Second.
Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? Vote affirmative. It passes.
Thank you.
Next is item three, receive information on various boards, commissions. First, we have Accommodations Tax Advisory Committee.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to waive the rules to nominate and appoint Daniel Matthew, and if somebody can pronounce that last name so I don't walk all over it.
Sirik.
Sirik.
Kasirik.
Kasirik, okay. Thank you.
Have a motion.
Second.
And a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? Vote affirmative. It passes.
Mr. Chairman, I have a gentleman that I want to bring forward, but we did have a small problem with paperwork, and I'm going to bring his name next one.
Okay. Okay, Mr. Brown. Appalachian Council of Governments.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to waive the rules and accept and reappoint Mr. Charles Chet Morris to that position.
Second.
Have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? Vote affirmative. It passes.
Mr. Chairman, Mr. Tilson has agreed. He just hadn't got his file back in yet. Okay. So it should be here next month.
Board of Appeals, we need to carry over. Economic, Community and Economic Development Loan Committee. Looks like they are in the process of amending the bylaws. We need to carry that over. Disability and Special Needs.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to waive the rules and nominate and appoint Scott Mercer.
Second.
Have a motion and a second from Dr. Mercer. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? Vote affirmative. It passes. Anyone else? Henry Fire District, do we need to carry it over?
Yes, that's just been submitted, so we'll carry that over to next month.
Fire Prevention and Protection.
Mr. Chairman, waive the rules, nominate and appoint Scott Miller and Phil Caruso.
We have a motion from Scott Miller and Phil Caruso. How many of all those positions need to be filled, right?
Mr. Chairman, also at this time.
Let's finish over. Don't okay. We have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative. Passes. Now, Dale.
Okay. This time, I'd like to waive rules and nominate Mr. Jim Redd for that position.
Second.
Have a motion and a second from Mr. Redd. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. Opposed? Affirmative. It passes.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to waive the rules and nominate and re-elect or reappoint Mr. Patrick Evett.
Have a motion. Mr. Evett.
Second.
And a second. Now any discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. Opposed? Affirmative. It passes. David?
I'd like to waive the rules and nominate elect John H. Hall, Jr.
H. Hall Jr. Have a motion.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. Vote affirmative. It passes.
Mr. Chairman, it's noted that one of the initial appointees for this Fire Prevention and Protection Advisory Committee would be ineligible for reappointment, and Mr. David Ron Nordenrock has made mention that he would waive his ability to be reappointed. So we accept that.
And we still have to get some information in from Chief Hatt. That's forthcoming.
Anything else, Dick? Okay, thank you. Hobbiesville, Jane?
Yes, we are in the works with that, and I do want to make a mention that a longtime commissioner passed away, so we also have that seat vacant as well. Mr. William Sin passed away this month, so that will be an appointment to fill that vacancy for his unexpired term.
All right, we have page two. Spartanburg County Planning Commission, and it says to carry over.
I will contact Dr. Turner Williams, since she's my district informant in Vernon Harrell's Club, so I think we still got some time, but I'll contact them, and if they're not interested, then we'll start, I think, both of them, the same other files.
Pretty important committee, so.
Question on this right here, when we got District 5, is that still District 5 or Council District 5?
He's actually in my council district, so. All right, he'll be reappointed, he'll turn in the paperwork.
Spartanburg County Fuel and Mow Board of Appeals.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to waive the rules, nominate-elect Louise Ricks.
Got a motion?
Second.
And a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, and it passes.
Mr. Chairman, my district informant is KW Fleming, and she knows about me today. Did she get her bio here that David Morris will have her ready for next month?
Does anybody, she want to participate?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next, we have committees, and the first is Economic Improvement and Development. Honorable David Britt, Chairman, Malcolm Brown, Roger Nutt, members. Mr. Britt?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. We have one item for us. We have a request to adopt a resolution consenting to the assignment of a special source revenue agreement between Spartanburg County and Merritt Leasing LLC. Do we hear a motion to approve this resolution?
Move.
Second. Motion made and seconded. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries. We recommend full council. Who's our committee?
Thank you, Mr. Britt. No items under public health today. We have personnel and finance. Honorable Dale Coberts, Chairman. Jeff Porter and Jane Hall, members. Mr. Coberts?
Mr. Chairman, we have a couple items coming for our committee today. The first is receive information, take desired action in reference to an ordinance amending ordinance number 0-07-25 to revise the decertification criteria for rehabilitating historic property subject to special property tax assessment. Captain O'Neill is going to present us on this.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. This really is a housekeeping matter. The county's current ordinance needs to come into compliance with a recent amendment to the state statutes regarding this particular activity. In essence, what was happening under our ordinance is that when the ownership transferred for the property, it ended up decertifying the particular location. So the proposed ordinance that you have before you allows the sale and transfer of ownership during the special assessment period without it decertifying the property.
Okay. At this time, can I entertain a motion that we render first reading of this ordinance?
Motion.
Second.
Motion and second. Is there any discussion? Be no discussion. All those in favor, let it be known by the raise of the right hand. So carries. All right, the next item coming for us is to receive information, take desired action in reference to a part-time drug court position. And Mr. David Forrester going to present on this.
Thank you. We have increased our client load with drug court. We've seen more people now than we've had in close to 10 years. So what we would like to do without increasing our budget is to shift some money around so we can hire a part-time person that would help us stay on top of the clients that we have. It's about as simple as I can say.
So there is no change in budget?
No. Bottom line stays the same.
At this time, could I entertain a motion that we approve the increasing of this part-time position?
Motion.
Second. Motion and second. Any discussion? Yes, Kathy?
Mr. Chairman, if I can add that there is a budget amendment resolution that realigns the cost to accommodate this particular request if council approves it. So there is a change in the budget, but as Mr. Forrester noted, the bottom line doesn't change.
Is that in our list of VARs?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you have a note? Any other discussion? Need no further discussion. All those in favor, let me know by raising the right hand. So carries. Next was the receive updated financial data and personnel matrix report that's in all of our packets. Does anybody have any questions on that at this time? Mr. Chairman, that's all we have. That concludes our meeting.
Thank you, Mr. Coleman. Judge Eubanks, good to see you, my friend.
Nice to see all of you. Thank
Always.
You, Mr. Chairman.
Yes, sir, buddy.
Pleasure to be here.
That's Brian. Brian, doing okay? Good.
Thank you.
Thank you. Sorry. I speak to my old friend. Next, we have a little building committee. Honorable Jane Hall, Chairman. David Britt, Michael Brown, Member.
Today we are having information and to take desired action in reference to the acquisition of the Chesney Senior Citizen. And Catherine O'Neill will present.
Madam Chair, the staff is recommending that council proceed with purchasing the Chesney Senior Center. What we'd like to do is to ask you to authorize me to enter into a contract for the purchase of the property so we can take the next step forward with this program.
Okay. We need a motion to authorize the county administrator to execute this contract in the purchase of the Senior Citizen Center in Chesney for a purchase price not to exceed $100 plus closing costs and to execute all documents necessary to complete this purchase.
So moved.
Okay. So we have a motion and a second. All those in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Thank you. And we also are going to be receiving some activities of the Parks Department. And let me just start off by saying that the Spartanburg County Parks Department recently brought home two significant victories for Spartanburg County. We are proud to officially announce that National Softball Association has chosen to return to Spartanburg with the NSA Eastern Fast Pitch World Series in July of 2014. And we know that we experienced a tremendous partnership with the city of Spartanburg and creating an event of just master proportions last time. And our team is already working with the city of Spartanburg to reinvent that event as well. But also, Spartanburg won the bid to host the Amateur Softball Association's 18 and up ASA USA Nationals in July of 2015. This is one of the most prestigious tournaments in the country. It will bring the top softball teams from all 50 states, not just the Southeast, but all 50 states, to Spartanburg for the week-long event. Spartanburg beat out cities from Alabama, Florida, South Dakota, Tennessee, Mississippi for this prestigious event. And Spartanburg will be the first city in South Carolina to ever host this. But I'd like to have Dennis Hodges with the Parks Department please come up. And first of all, I would like to thank him and his staff for the tremendous work that they do in promoting Spartanburg County. And I also see Chris Jennings back there and all of his staff. And I know we have one young lady who just got back from some trips. And we know that you are a big voice for Spartanburg as well, so thank you. And before you talk, Dennis, I just want to applaud you for everything.
I just wanted to kind of give you a little background on the on how competitive that ASA bid. This was our fourth year going there and bidding. We finally won it. We took a We had a plan, we started planning for this back in about January, put a team together that traveled to Oklahoma City to showcase Spartanburg to the world. We're now on the national stage as far as softball tournaments goes. There's only five of those tournaments awarded each year to communities throughout the country, and Spartanburg was one of them. But I'd like to recognize Hope Brewer, Marsha Murph, Kristen Smith, Elizabeth Hardy, and Trey Glover in the back as well. We all went out there and we worked hard for Spartanburg, and we are excited. I think Trey actually may have some injuries when that boat popped up and I tackled him. And I'm proud of that. It usually takes two or three votes because you have to get the majority. We won on the very first vote, 54.8% of the vote, and we just couldn't believe it, but we're so excited to showcase Spartanburg to the country and our premier facilities. But also, it just wasn't us, this team of individuals. There are some other people that I want to recognize. Chris Jennings with the CPB, with all their support they provide us, as well as county administration and county council as well. If we didn't have your all support, we'd never be in the position we're in. And not only that, just the community of Spartanburg. You know, we bring them here, but Spartanburg showcases why we're so happy to have these people come into our community to spend their money. But just want to say thank you, and we're excited for this opportunity.
Thank you so much. Thanks. And once again, thank you. And this just speaks volumes for the history of softball that we've experienced here in Spartanburg County. And this is a new future history that we are creating for Spartanburg when it comes to fast pitch softball. So thank you so much. Okay, Mr. Chairman, that's it for our committee.
Jane, Mr. Chairman, one quick thing. Because I don't know if y'all are going to be around here for very long, but...
Well, I hope they're going to be here for a long
time. I mean, I'm talking about this evening. I don't know if y'all are going to leave after this. You know, so many people, you know, y'all do so much work, and you affect so many people, not just in the parks and rec area, and not just the citizens that are living here get to enjoy this, you know, the facilities and all the excitement. But you just can't believe and understand the effect that you have on economic development. I mean, the positives, you know, when you go to Oklahoma City, it's written up, boom. All the companies that we're working with, they're looking every time Spartanburg's name pops up on anything on the AP or whatever, it just registers with them. It sends a signal. And we've had some tremendous opportunities this year that we're looking at. I mean, Carter Smith, Brian Nash, they're not in here yet because they're working on another company. But the impact that y'all are making on economic development that will, you know, rise a tide and float all the boats here is significant. I mean, it's just big. You'll see sooner than later, but thank you on, you know, from the economic development side too.
You know, when we go back to what's going on in Spartanburg, the buzz about industry and livability, and this is what this committee is about. It's what makes it wonderful to be in Spartanburg County. But with that said, I'm probably one of these weird councilmen sitting up here. Because I actually go to Tiger River Park. Mr. Hodges will attest that I'm there usually twice a day walking the dog. But especially on the weekends when we have the big tournaments, I walk through the parking lots and I look at the license tags of the cars. And it is a tremendous to see Virginia and Alabama and Tennessee and Florida and all of the Georgia and North Carolina, all of these different cars that are here in Spartanburg County for the weekend. And I actually, when I can, stop and talk with some of these people. And they are amazed at Spartanburg County's park and what it offers. And I've even had people say, you know, my husband's not doing too well in his job. And we're actually looking at Spartanburg and the surrounding area to move to. So this says volumes for what message we give to the rest of the country when we have such great playing fields and organizations that take advantage of this. And, you know, that's also what industry is looking for as well. They want to make sure that their people are going to be happy when they uproot and move somewhere. And what better place to come to than Spartanburg, South Carolina? So thank you. You are a big part of this, and we really do appreciate what you all do. So thank you. Mr. Chairman.
Thank you. Next, we have Public Safety and Judiciary, Honorable Michael Brown, Chairman, Roger Nutt, Tail Coverage Member. Mr. Brown.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. We have two items coming before the committee. The first one is receiving information and take desired action in reference to adjusting the emergency medical service rates. Here to present the Director of Emergency Medical Service here in Spartanburg, Mr. Jimmy Glenn.
Thank you. I think in your package you've got basically two pages. The first thing I want to say is that this is a normal thing that we do to show you where the rates are as compared to other systems. And you will see that we have rates in here from Greenville, Lexington, Horry, Charleston, and then Medic in Charlotte. Then we did an analysis that shows you the lowest, the highest, average, and then compared that to the present rate. On the second page, the one that says EMS rate analysis, we showed you what current charges are, what those charges render in billed revenue, and then collected revenue out of that 16.1 million. Collected revenue is about 9.1, 9.2 million. And then if you took the average charges and used those, we should have shown you what you would see in rendered revenue as proposed revenue bill. And then the increase in that revenue would be about $4.8 million. But then we have analyzed that to show you what the actual collected revenue would be, which is $105,000. So basically, if you did a rate increase of the average, you would generate $4.8 million in billed revenue, but you're only going to see collected revenue of $105,000. Now, the reason for that is 73% of the patients that we serve with EMS are on Medicare and Medicaid. No matter how much you do, whatever you do to your rates, those charges are set by the federal government and they stay the same and it doesn't impact those. So the only impact you got is 27% that's not Medicare, Medicaid. Part of that would be commercial insurance, part of it would be self-pay or uninsured.
Jimmy, I apologize.
Sure.
Do you have a percentage on what the commercial insurance would be versus self-pay?
Self-pay is roughly, out of the 27%, about 11%, and the rest of it would be commercial. So you got about 16% that's commercial. So at this point, I'll take any questions. We present this as information, and then council's decision if they want to increase rates, keep them the same, or whatever.
Can you tell us a little bit about when the last time we increased our rates and kind of give us an overview of what, if so, what percentage of an increase that was?
The rates increased about 5 years ago. But Mr. Nutt, I don't remember what the percentage was, but it would have been a very small percent, probably something in the 2% range. And the reason would have been because that would have been what the Medicare increase was for that year. Since that time, Medicare has actually decreased rates every year. We have not come back and proposed to decrease rates, but we're collecting less of Medicare in particular. We do anticipate in January seeing another decrease in Medicare reimbursement again. But FY09 would have been the last increase of EMS rates.
So if we look at this on the The 27% is self-pay. Jimmy, give me a ballpark figure as to, let's just say, you know, I had an accident, I'm self-pay. How much is it going to go up for maybe 24?
Well, that's up to council. If you look at the rate, if it's a, we'll say it's a basic life support rate, currently it's 423. If it went to the average, that would be 560. What we tried to do on this rate analysis was show you for each category what the increase would be in both billed revenue and projected collected revenue.
Is there a chance that, how much does that fluctuate, that 27%? Is it pretty stable every year? I mean, can we pretty much say that the billed revenue and the collected revenue, that's going to be a pretty firm number? I mean, you know, for somebody to look at and say, oh, you are getting this big $4 million windfall increase in fees, how assured are we that there is a 27% that's going to be effective, that's going to really be the collected rate?
It's been consistent probably for the last 5 to 6 years. I wouldn't anticipate much change. The only change that I think you'll see is under affordable care. It's predicted that more people will have insurance, so you may see less self-pay and more of the commercial insurance if that takes place. But that would be the biggest change that I think you could count on coming forward.
We've seen an increase in Medicaid and Medicare over the last couple of months, I know the country in general is seeing a vast increase in people looking on Medicaid.
We haven't seen with EMS, we haven't seen an increase. It's been fairly consistent for the last 5 to 6 years in the percentage of patients that we see that are covered by Medicare and Medicaid.
Dale, may I have a comment on that? I think Washington cut Medicare funding $400 million. So sooner or later, that's going to trickle down to you.
And it's been cut a little bit each year for the last 4 years. And we do anticipate again in January we'll get the new rates. We may get them in sometime in December. We do anticipate that Medicare reimbursement will go down again. No one knows exactly how much, but I would guess it would be 2-3%, somewhere in that category probably.
Mr. Chairman, would it be appropriate to ask the question about what the county contributes to EMS at this time?
Sure. Mr. Chairman, in this fiscal year, it's roughly $2.1 million.
So that's the county's amount that we provided for EMS for its function.
Yes.
Could we go out on a limb and make a rough guess? Is that an average number for the last 5 years, or what was the fluctuation of the last 5 year period?
We went through an audit last year, and that ended up changing the county's contribution. We went through that during the budget process. So our contributions may have been in the 1.2, 1.3, 1.5 million, but we had to make a significant adjustment to that this fiscal year in order to address the audit changes that we saw. Is that a fair recap?
And to recoup the ambulance lease amount. And to kind of give you a picture of where we've been, 2000, the county's portion was about $3 million. So we're 2.1 now. It's been as low as probably 1.2 or something in that neighborhood. So it's fluctuated probably the last 5 years from 1.2 up to the 2.1 that we're at now.
And if we go out on a limb here and say that, you know, in this next year that this would generate another $105,000 for us, Catherine, would we be safe in saying that that would decrease the amount of money that we make as a contribution to EMS every year, our taxpayers?
That would certainly be something that you could discuss during the budget process. We would show you the revenues that are coming in from EMS and then how much it costs to provide the service. And certainly these additional revenues would show in that illustration. And you could decide how you want to proceed with what Mr. Green brings forward in his budget for what he needs for next fiscal year.
Jimmy, I'll be honest with you, when I first looked at this, you know, I always go to the bottom numbers, and when I saw $4 million, I said, wow, we're not doing this. But, you know, in light of the fact that 73% of that, you know, is dictated by federal government through Medicare and Medicaid, I can see the big picture a little better.
Well, and that's why we wanted to bring this before council, just so you have a good picture of what's going on. And, you know, a lot of times people say, well, just adjust your rates. You can adjust the rates, but you're not getting a whole lot of benefit out of any rate adjustment. But we wanted you to see, you know, exactly where it stood in comparison to other counties, and then to give you a realistic projection of if you increase the rates to that average, it's about $105,000 is what you're going to actually collect.
Mr. Green, may I cover this, but what's your annual budget for this year?
Total budget, it's about $11.3.
Repeat that again, please.
$11.2 or $11.3, collect about $9 to $9.1 million from patient revenues, and then the county's portion is a $2.1.
Jimmy, not pertaining to this, I just want to tell you, thank you for the job you do on the, I believe it was May the 3rd, first Saturday in May of this year. I had the opportunity to ride one of the EMS units, didn't really want to be there, but.
You weren't unruly or anything, were you?
No, I actually told the guys that I would tell you how good a job they done. I don't remember their names, but they transported me from Pelham to the Heart Center at 4 o'clock in the afternoon. But those guys are very professional, done a great job, and I've always, I think we have a great EMS system here. Thank you for what you do.
Thank you.
Yeah, I just wanted to say, the chairman made the comment about cuts to Medicaid. If we don't do this now, we're going to be faced with it next year, because we're going to have bigger cuts. And kind of echoing what O'Neill said, take what we were 20 years ago, you know, it comes to EMS and dialing 911, we're light years ahead of where we were, and chiefly because Jimmy Green and his team were. We had so many rescue squads, remember all those, scattered across the county, and it wasn't a guarantee you're going to get to the hospital in any certain amount of time. But now, you dial 911, the difference between paying $423 or $560 is worth every penny, because you know they're going to get you where you need to be in a hurry with professional help.
Thank you.
With that, I can entertain a motion for the specific amount that's being requested for the EMS adjusted rate of $4,793,984.
So moved.
Mr. Chairman, I'll second that motion.
Proper movement, second. All in favor, let me know as aye.
Aye.
Committee will submit this to full council for its consideration. Thank you, Jimmy. Second item coming before the committee is desire to receive information, take desired action in reference to a request from the Spartanburg Emergency Management Department to apply for a local emergency management performance grant. Doug Price is here to present information in regards to that grant application.
Good afternoon. This grant is from Department of Homeland Security and is administered through the South Carolina Emergency Management Division to support community emergency response team, or CERT, programs. We're blessed. We have the largest single county CERT program in the state of South Carolina. In the 8 years since I've been here, we've trained over 600 citizens on various aspects of emergency preparedness and things like that. And their primary use is to supplement first responders, maybe fire service or law enforcement. And every year we can apply for a grant to help maintain and sustain this program, replace equipment, upgrade equipment, things like that. There's no match, or no hard match, it's in-kind match.
Questions, comments?
Chairman, at this time I'd like a motion to approve the grant application submitted.
Second. Proper movement, second. All in favor, let it be known as aye.
Aye.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Chairman, full council. We have information in our package regarding the Buildings Code Department. That's all matters before this committee, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Mr. Brown. Mr. Mance, for the record, EMS sent me a memo that day and said they took you directly to Buck Creek Road because they couldn't hear maintenance. True or not? No, he did have great things to say about you, Jimmy. You're a guy. No items under land use, no items under public works today. We will adjourn at 5 o'clock. We have the Citizens Academy, and then at 5:30, we will move for the council meeting. Thank you very much for your attendance. Okay, thank you very much for your attendance. Earlier today, we had our committee meeting, and first item on the agenda is our invocation. Captain Clevenger, if you would, please.
Let us pray. Our most gracious Heavenly Father, as we come to you this afternoon, this is a month that we celebrate Thanksgiving. There are so many reasons, Father, why we celebrate. Because we give thanks to you for this country. What a beautiful country. For this beautiful state. And we're very thankful, Father, for this beautiful county that you have given to us. As we stand tonight in the midst of this county government with this young lady and six young men who sit in council, we pray for them and give thanksgiving to you for them and what they're doing for this county. We pray, Lord, that you'd help them, give them wisdom, give them understanding, give them knowledge. Give them times when they can see things that only you can show. We are very thankful for this county, for the young people who make this run smoothly each and every day. For our county administrator and the blessing that she has been since she has been here. So many others, her assistants, and all the others that make so much. We're very thankful. Thank you for this county. May it forever be true to you. And may your grace rest upon it. For it's in the name of Jesus we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Chaplain. Next, we have our Pledge of Allegiance. James, who leads today?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, James. Next, call David to have a motion on adding something to the agenda.
Mr. Chairman, I respectfully request that council entertain a motion to amend the main agenda to add an item number 3 in between numbers 2 and 4 to permit the county administrator to provide employee recognition. This is just an inadvertent omission of that. Just want to add to the agenda.
So, second. A motion and a second. Any discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, and it passes. Thank you, Dave. Next, we have item 2, presentations. And the first presentation will be given by Mr. O'Neill Mintz, and it's a resolution congratulating and recognizing James Cooley for being named 2013 Swisher Sweet Sun Belt Expo Southeastern Farmer of the Year. Mr. Cooley, I saw you come in. Come on up, buddy. You didn't get to sit down very long, did you?
Mr. Cooley, bring your family with you.
Thank you.
good-looking grandkids come here. I've actually, this one right here, Brooks just told me, in the nursery at the church, I crawled under a table with him. He didn't think I could get under it. He crawled under it. I got home. Jim, if you would come on up here, it's certainly a privilege to have you here. It's a longtime friend to all the family, probably the greatest farmer that I've ever known. I'm going to give him a plug. He's got strawberries in right now. Most people don't know that strawberries, you know, that you have a fall strawberry. He's got strawberries in right now. And I will assure you that they taste like candy. They are fabulous. I stopped by the other day on my way to Canada. I was a little bit disappointed they were sold out. I didn't carry my Canada with me, but thank you for all you do for our community. I know the input that you've had in the Chester community, you and your wife Kathy and all your children, Brooks and Brandy and Brittany and Bethany. Did I get them all right?
Yes.
And that's all. If you haven't visited Strawberry Hill, I would strongly, strongly advise you. This is a great time to do it while they've got their fall strawberries in. A resolution congratulating and recognizing James Cooley for being named the 2013 Swisher Sweets Sunbelt Expo Southeastern Farmer of the Year. Whereas pride and honor have been bestowed upon Spartanburg County by the achievements of James Cooley. And on October the 15th, 2013, James Cooley was announced as the winner of the award during the opening day of the Sunbelt Ag Expo in Moultrie, Georgia, and is only the second farmer from South Carolina to win this regional award. This award is given to a farmer who is recognized for excellence in agricultural production and farm management, along with leadership in farm and community organizations. The award also honors family contributions in producing safe and abundant supplies of food, fiber, and shelter products for U.S. consumers. James Cooley has been a farmer for 34 years, operating a farm operation that spans 1,188 acres of land, where he works alongside his family in the production of peaches, strawberries, and blackberries, and also owns and operates the Strawberry Hill USA Cafe, where annually between 500,000 and 1,000,000 customers come to enjoy a farm tour, lunch, and the Cooley homemade ice cream, and I enjoy all three. Now, therefore, be it resolved that Spartanburg County Council does hereby recognize James Cooley for his many contributions through his work in the farming community and congratulates him on his being named the 2013 Swisher Sweets Sunbelt Expo Southeastern Farmer of the Year. Be it further resolved that this resolution be presented to James Cooley in recognition thereof and be made a part of the permanent minutes of Spartanburg County Council adopted this 18th day of November 2013. This is signed by Jeffrey A. Horton, Chairman of Spartanburg County Council, and is also signed and attested by Catherine O'Neill, County Administrator. Mr. Chairman, I move to adopt.
I move it. Second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? Vote affirmative. It passes. Thank you, Mr. Mint.
Right here. Can't this stuff up here?
And I'd also like you to know, I think James and the family knows that when Ms. O'Neill came here as our administrator, she spent a half day with each council member in their district. The first place we went was for lunch at Strawberry Hill.
I appreciate it very much.
I'm going to start a 30-minute speech.
Now, I'd like to say I appreciate each and every one of what you do for our county and our state. And I just want everybody to know that when I go anywhere that they know I'm from Spartanburg County, South Carolina. I appreciate that each and every person. And what they do for our business alone, and we're just so proud to be here. Thank you very kindly.
Next item on the agenda, Bill and I got in a big fight behind the scenes, and he pulled out some weaponry on me, and we won. Read this next resolution. Dale, I'm going to go ahead and make your way forward. next person we're recognizing. We grew up together. She started teaching school when she was 12. She taught me in high school.
You know, Jeff's going to fiddle around here and tell a lie, Mama, so y'all just keep listening.
She's not going to, she's not willing before the meeting. She can't say anything that happened back then. So, item B, resolution congratulating and recognizing Wanda L. Fowler for her dedicated service as an educator for Spartanburg County.
Ladies and gentlemen, I get to do some fun things in my job. I get to do some hard things. But this right here, honoring special people in Spartanburg County is by far the happiest part of my job. And the lady that we're going to honor here this evening is one of the most honored people and one of the closest people in my heart in prayers. And we've got Wanda Fowler. Wanda, if you would come up. And we have some people from an organization that I love, the Middle Tiger Community Center, with us. We have our new director, Andrea Moore. I want you guys to come up and be with Wanda. Just come on up. We'll have a group here.
We have some board members here
now. We got some board members. I'm going to let you introduce them here in just a moment, since we introduce you. Guys, these right here are some great people, and I just can't say enough about this young lady right here. 7 years ago, when I took office, I inherited a wardship on the Middle Tiger Community Center, and I don't mind telling you, I didn't have a clue how much my job was going to entail. And I mean, I was overwhelmed in the first few weeks. I really did want. I was thinking, wow, I've bit off a lot to chew on here. And I got to thinking about all these different things I was involved with, and I talked to Chairman Horton. I said, can I get out of some of these duties, and maybe, you know, my time is just not going to be enough for it. And the Middle Tiger Community Center was one of the things that I was about to decide that I just really couldn't devote myself to. Wanda Fowler called me up one day. She said, Dale, I need you to come over and take a tour of the center and spend a day with us, or a morning with us. I went over there, and folks, my heart melted. It really did. We did so many great things, and I'm going to let Wanda or Andrea want to tell you a little bit about what we do over at Middle Tiger Community Center in just a moment. But spending a couple hours with Wanda over here at the community center, I couldn't say no. I couldn't say no. I cried. And I must tell you this too. This lady right here, Jeff, you need to testify to this too. You don't say no to her. You don't want to, because she'll come to you and present it in a way you have to say yes, because she always wants you to do the right thing. I want to honor you tonight, Wanda. You're such a blessing to us. Congratulating and recognizing Wanda L. Fowler for her dedicated service as an educator for Spartanburg County. Whereas pride and honor have been bestowed upon Spartanburg County by a dedicated service of Wanda L. Fowler, and whereas she has been an educator her entire adult life. And you started at 12. That was 12.
Well, I did not say that Jeff told us.
Yeah, he don't mind about that part. And she's always bragging about Jeff. Now, she might prefer a tale a little bit. Okay. And serving for 21 years as teaching classes at USC Upstate and classes for teachers across South Carolina, and serving as Director of Graduate Regional Studies at the University of South Carolina. And whereas Wanda L. Fowler is notably known for her tireless efforts in the program implementation and her service as Executive Director of the Middle Tiger Community Center located in Lima, South Carolina for the past 15 years. Whereas under Wanda L. Fowler's leadership, the Middle Tiger Community Center grew from 2 programs when it opened its doors in 1988 to now 16 programs that bring together community, local, state agencies to support Spartanburg County School District 5 area and adjoining areas of the county and upstate of South Carolina, and to assist hundreds of families and children annually. Whereas during her professional career, she received numerous awards and accolades, including Boyle Springs High School Teacher of the Year, Outstanding Service to the School District's Award, Community and School Service Award, Women of Achievement Award, Community Champion Award, Service to Mankind Award, Distinguished Public Service Award, and Citizen of the Year. Now, therefore, be it resolved that Spartanburg County Council does hereby recognize Wanda L. Fowler for her many contributions to the education of the community of Spartanburg County, and to congratulate her on her retirement from the Middle Tiger Community Center. Be it further resolved that this resolution be presented to Wanda L. Fowler in recognition thereof, and made part
of the permanent minutes of Spartanburg County adopted this 18th day of November 2013, attested by Catherine L. Village County Administrator and Jeffrey Horton, Chairman. Mr. Chairman, I move that we accept this resolution.
I have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, it passes.
Wanda, thank you so much for everything that you've done. And I want you to introduce our board members up here and our new director. And I want you to tell them a little bit about what we did.
Okay. We have several board members present tonight. Dale is one of our board members. We've been very fortunate from the very beginning with the steering committee. The House of Representatives of our district serves on the board and also the county council. Andrea Moore is our new director, and we're very delighted to have Andrea. I'm personally excited to have her taking over the next 15 years of Little Tiger Community Center. And Haley Grau came to us as an intern. We grow our people, and she is now an employee at Middle Tiger Community Center. We're very happy to have Haley. And we have Tanya Mart, who is a board member, Amber Scruggs, a board member, Michael Han, a board member, and Carl Hensey. Carl represents SEW Drive. Michael Han is retired from IBM. Amber is with BMW, and Tanya is with Michelin. We also have Michael's wife here, Joanne, who is a volunteer at Middle Tiger Community Center, and we may have some other volunteers here that I don't know about. I would like to just say before I have Andrea tell you what we do at Middle Tiger, I would just like to say that the outcomes, the very successful outcomes that we have at Middle Tiger Community Center are all reflective of the partnerships that we have. We partner with Spartanburg County School District 2, Spartanburg County School District 5. We also have support from our businesses. As you see, our churches last year with District 5 Family Ministries, we served over 1,000 children at Christmas. We have a food pantry that we serve families every day. Our outcomes from teen pregnancy, and Andrea, I'm kind of getting into the program here. But I just want to say this, and you know, I don't always have this captive audience, so I'm sorry, y'all. But it's so important that we realize sometimes in life we think that the problems are too big and that we can't do anything, and we're so little. But I want you to know, pregnancy program, which is adolescent family life in both District 2 and District 5, has had such wonderful outcomes that I think you need to know about it. In the nation and in the state, only 40% of our girls who become pregnant as a teen ever finish high school. Our girls, over 90% are finishing high school. That is astronomical. In the nation, 29% of girls who become pregnant as a teen have a second pregnancy between 16 and 20 months. Over a five-year research period, less than 5% of ours in 5 years experienced another pregnancy. 100% of our children are immunized. So these are very important outcomes, and when we think we're little and we can't do anything, just remember we are making changes, and these outcomes are very important because you have helped bring about these outcomes. We have received support from Spartanburg County, and I thank you very much. My part has been very little, and I thank you for this recognition.
Much. Well, very briefly, Middle Tiger is a comprehensive community center, and our goal is to create strong, healthy, self-sufficient families in this community. And Wanda mentioned our Adolescent Family Life program. That is one of the programs we offer. We have adult education, early childhood education, a family counseling center that is one of only three in the county that provides a sliding scale based on income. So, including free counseling for those who can't afford anything at all. And so we're able to provide counseling for adults and children and families in need through that. And our big project that we're working on is trying to bring a health clinic to our area as well.
You can understand why I say that I never say no to Wanda. She's great. Andrea, congratulations on you. You've got some big shoes to fill, but I feel confident that you can do it. And if you do have an opportunity, I'd like to challenge you. Go take a tour of this center, and I promise you, you'll be hooked. And you'll be wanting to help. God bless y'all. Thank you.
Thank you.
I see Dr. Mercer here today from District 2 Superintendent. I was first graduating class in your new high school, and so wanted to talk there the first year, but that didn't open up. It's been a long time. By the way, I was in the facility, and I'll be there Thursday, but y'all keep it in great shape. You're doing a magnificent job keeping those schools up. You really did.
Thanks so much.
Next, we have item C. We have Mr. Jim Headley here, the Executive Director, SE Recreation Parks Association, to represent the award for the Tiger River Park being named Park of the Year. And I want to thank him, first of all, for taking time out to come to Spartanburg today to give us this recognition. It took a lot of time for him to come and represent this award again. Jim, I'll come forward. Jake, if you will, come on up with me.
Good evening. Thank you, Chairman Horton, and members of County Council and citizens of Spartanburg. It brings me great pleasure to be able to come here this evening to kind of turn the tables a little bit, where y'all have been honoring some wonderful citizens and programs throughout the throughout your county, to represent an award to let you all know what a great impact both amongst the people as well as economically of what Tiger River has meant to Spartanburg County. On behalf of the Board of Directors and its over 100 public park and recreation agencies throughout the state, again, it gives me great pleasure to represent the 2003 Park Excellence Award to Tiger River for population 30,000 and over to Spartanburg County. What began as 137 acres in the middle of apple and peach orchard has since become the state-of-the-art $17.6 million baseball-softball facility known as Tiger River Park. The park features 12 youth baseball-softball fields in addition to a championship stadium in the field accommodating baseball for all ages, 4 to 15, and softball at all levels. I would especially like to take a moment back and like to thank Council for its vision and its forethought. That please, when you look at this and when you look at other facilities, that you look at it as much more than just a park. Because if we look at this as just a park, then we could have spent that money building tiddlywinks or something else. Council had the forethought to be able to say, you know what, it's worth it. It's worth it to the citizens of South Carolina. It's worth it definitely to the citizens of Spartanburg County. And if we continue to look at just parks, we are shortchanging what, in this case, is really an economic driver in the community. If it were a typical economic development project, council would go out and spend millions of dollars, build a business park, and then the citizens would never get to see it again. We are so lucky in the Parks and Recreation, we get to share that back with the citizens of Spartanburg County, and that is so vitally important. With public parks and recreation, not only do we attract new dollars coming in, but we also get to give back to the citizens who have given so much to their county. And then also, it then becomes a true asset for the county and is on the books for the county as to be a true asset. There's much more to Tiger River than just the ball fields. For those of you that have not been out there, it's a safe, lighted place to exercise, walk your dog, walk your children, walk your grandchildren, picnic with family, and bring that bond back together that we really so desperately miss in this country, is that family unity. And that's what parks do. So parks are an integral part of what governmental entities need to provide and what they do provide. Visitors from all over the United States have been playing at the park and confirmed the Tiger River is truly a park of excellence. With an economic impact of just this past year alone of over $17.6 million in its first year of operation, Tiger River has exceeded everybody's expectations. Chris Jennings, Spartanburg Convention and Visitors Bureau Executive Director, stated that Spartanburg has gained national publicity for hosting youth sports events, specifically baseball and softball tournaments at the new Tiger River Park. With the NSA World Series event slated to return in the summer of 2014, and just with the recent addition, for those of you that don't know, Spartanburg County was just awarded a national tournament in 2015 and 2016. Just all more good things are going to come to Spartanburg County. And this without being on the tax burden of the local citizens. This project was funded 100% and bonded through the hospitality tax. So those that go out and eat, those that go play in those ball tournaments, come back and support this great facility that the citizens now do get to enjoy as well as bringing in national softball and baseball tournaments. So with this, I trust that you have a park that will be an asset and be enjoyed by not only the people all over the country, but definitely the citizens of Spartanburg. So with that, Chairman Horton, I'd like to present to you and the council and to the citizens of Spartanburg County the 2013 Park Excellence Award for Tiger River Park and Playground, Parks and population of 30,000 and over to Spartanburg County.
Jim, I'd like to say that, again, a vision for this park started 20 years ago, and our former Parks and Rec Director here tonight, Jeff Caton, and 20 years ago, we went around the county and we had public hearings and tried to determine, the next step for Spartanburg County. And the one thing that we heard throughout the county was, if you're going to build another park, we had a ran down Cleveland Park at the time, don't bring a park near me. So that vision started 20 years ago, and I want to thank everyone through the years that's had a hand in participating with these programs. Again, earlier we had recognition, it's not one person, it's not one group, it's been an entire organization through the years to make this park a reality. And in the words of our former council member who passed away, Ms. Johnny Cohen Stewart, this is one where we turn rhetoric into reality. So we hope that there's more of these entities here in the future. But again, thank you everyone that had a hand involved in this project.
I'd like to also say thank you. And it's been a process. It's been something that started 20 years ago with a different council and has continued on. When I became council member in 2009, I filled the shoes, or tried to, of my predecessor, who was Rock Adams, who really saw this as a vision, especially in the area of Spartanburg County that Tiger River Park settled in. So I thank him for all of his endless effort that he put forth with this as well. And this is only the beginning for Spartanburg County. We see one absolutely fabulous park, but we have a dedication of all of council and of all of the park staff that all of our parks are going to be parks that every person in Spartanburg County will be proud of, whether they're of a national level or if they're just a local place for people to come and play. Whatever it is, we want our parks to be the best that they can be. And this is one thank you for recognizing what we have done. So thank you very much.
Next, we'll proceed to the graduates class. You know, I had the pleasure the other night to meet this group, and I told McCaffrey this was form a group that really bonded together, and I'll tell you what, the other night and again tonight, and you seem like you had a lot of fun, and I want to thank you for taking time to go through this class, and as usual, Kathy, I want to thank you and your team for your hard work. I was talking with the city folks earlier today, and I encourage them to do the same thing in the city, because it's important that all the residents learn more about their government, local government, and so I appreciate you taking your time to participate. So with that being said, I'll start the recognition. Dwayne Anderson. I might say, this is the best crowd we've seen in a while. Casey Rains tomorrow. It's not going to rain today, I don't think. Mr. Jay Brown. Johnny M. Brown. I have an interpreter here to write, Ms. Trina Brand. Even when they got all the tax notices in the mail. Yeah. Yeah. Came the next day, I wore it again. Put it Carter.
right, Mr. Davis, good.
Thank you, thank you. Appreciate your
Michael Henderson. Okay, we have Terry Pierce, but we have a Joanne Jeter here to accept for Mr. Pierce tonight. How are you? Finally, an umbrella matching outfit. Beverly K. Robinson. Pamela Jean Samuels. D. Walker. Big class. You know, you have a couple over there. What do you have, 19 this year?
Yes.
Big class.
They're laughing at me because my real name is not on there.
That's not?
They were wanting you to say it.
Oh, what is
it? Well, I tell you, it's not any fun. Oh. I have to write it. You have to try it.
Oh, well, I don't know about my 12th grade teacher. She left.
Just a minute.
Okay. Here we go. Don't forget that. No? Yeah, I had. I know in the thing is about the 3rd grade, I had to get that hooked on phonics. So I will say my 6th grade teacher said, Jeff, when you move up next year, you don't need to take algebra. So, I took it anyway. Rodney Wells.
Shoot, yeah.
I'm sure you're very familiar with it, but I want to make sure the rest of the group knows that Mr. Cannon said that Chris was very polite, helpful, business-oriented, and helped them solve their problems. Now, we know that about Chris already, but something that Jim Cannon said really stuck with me. He said, Council, he wanted to make sure that You guys and I understand that Chris and the rest of Jerry's team is encouraging growth in this county. He said it was very heartwarming, Chris, to see people like and employees like you who are making Spartanburg County a better place to live. So, Chris, thank you so much. This isn't the first time I've recognized you, but I'm sure it won't be the last either. Thank you. Chairman, we'll have a few folks slip out here before I recognize our next employee. The next employee that I take great pride in recognizing, I'm sure that our clerk of court, Hope Blackley, also takes great pride in this, Maribel Martinez. If you would stand, I want you guys to see this smile. Maribel, I know that you didn't want to get this recognition. You were trying not to let folks know what a great job you're doing, and we just can't let that happen. You need this recognition. As I understand it, you were getting praise for customer service and a coworker overheard it and wanted to make sure that our clerk of court knew this. That's how much pride that this team has in knowing that their coworkers are doing an excellent job. And Maribel, if I'm not mistaken, you were on the phone helping someone regarding jury service. I've been in the office meeting with Hope before, and you were just a center of positive energy in the clerk's office. And I know that you have a lot on your plate. I don't think you mind me sharing this with counsel, but Maribel works two jobs. This is her primary job with us, and she puts that level of importance on it. But I know that you have an undying energy to make sure that our customers, the citizens of Spartanburg County, get the best service every day out of the clerk of court's office. And I know Hope has thanked you for this. Council, I want to thank you as well, and keep smiling. It really does brighten everyone's day. Thank you so much. That is my day. I'll just go see her to cheer up my day. So thank you. And then, Mr. Chairman and Council, I don't have these individuals here, but I wanted to take this moment just to acknowledge two very important things and recognition things that have happened and the recognition that we got. Our solicitor, Barry Barnett, he was named the South Carolina Law Enforcement Victim Advocate Association Solicitor of the Year just a few weeks ago. I'm going to try to get him back. He's not one to get a whole lot of recognition either. He's pretty humble, but I think he deserves to get a high five from us because that's quite an honor that was bestowed on him. And then Kim Danner, I don't see Kim here in the audience, or the folks from IT. I know that they've got a project that they're working on right now. Council, we have gone live with the ROD on base document management portion of phase two. We went live on October the 21st. I just want to give a high five to them. We'll have them in and recognize them, but to Dorothy Earle, her crowd, and the Register of Deeds Office and the IT, doing what you guys asked and doing it well. So thank you so much.
Yes, sir, Mr. Brand.
You know, I see a group that I know of, as of January 13th of this year, they celebrated their 100th birthday. And this group is very near and dear to this council. This is my predecessor, which always recognized that. Definitely stand on the shoulders of giants. They're here, and they're quite active in the community. In fact, I know some members of this year's graduating class for the Citizens Academy were actually in that class. And so I want to recognize the alumni chapter here in Spartanburg. They do carry on the tradition that Ms. Johnny Cole Stewart set in terms of community and public service. And I just want to recognize the ladies as they've come here this evening. And I said I want to do that. And you could just stand up and trust me, this is a small number. They really are probably the largest service-oriented organization in Spartanburg County. So I just want to say, ladies, thank you for carrying on the honor and the tradition of Ms. Johnny Cole Stewart, which presence here this evening and in the community. Thank you for coming.
Thank you.
This is Johnny Cole Stewart's daughter.
Oh, that's
right.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Well, Michael, I'm glad you brought that up. And it's good to see you. We love Ms. Stewart. And
and we always use her, I always use her term, and just about every speech we give when we're talking about tough issues and then having some accomplishment, and just turn that rhetoric into reality. And so we're very fortunate to have served with her through the years. Thank you. All right, come to item four, and I open public hearings. I open item A to consider an ordinance authorizing the execution and delivery of a fee in lieu and tax and incentive agreement between Spartanburg County and Kovacs Global Package. Anyone who can speak on behalf of this public hearing this evening? None seen, close item eight. Earlier today, we had our committee reports. First item on the agenda was economic recruitment and development. Honorable David Brick, Chairman. Mr. Brick.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Our committee recommends the full council to adopt a resolution consenting to the assignment of the special source revenue agreement between Spartanburg County and Merit Leasing LLC. We adopt this resolution.
We have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? All affirmative, and it passes. Concludes our committee report. Thank you, Mr. Brett. No items under public health. Personnel and finance. Honorable Dale Cover, the chairman. Mr. Cover.
Mr. Chairman, we have several items coming before our committee today. The first is to receive information and take desired action in reference to an ordinance amending ordinance number 0-07-25 to recertify the decertification criteria of rehabilitating historic property subject to a special tax assessment. Mr. Chairman, the committee recommends the full council that we approve and render first reading of this, and I so move.
Have a motion.
Second.
And a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? Vote affirmative, and it passes.
Thank you. Next item is to receive information and take desired action reference to a part-time drug court position. Mr. Chairman, the committee recommends that we approve the unfreezing of this part-time position, and I so move, Ms. Tanner.
Have a motion.
Second.
Second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? Vote affirmative, and it passes.
That's all we have, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Mr. Galbraith. Livability, Honorable Jane Hall, Chairman.
Yes, Mr. Chairman. We received information in reference to the acquisition of the Chesney Senior Center, and the committee moved to bring this to full council to authorize the county administrator to enter into a contract for the purchase of the property.
Second. I have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? Vote affirmative, and it passes.
We also received information on the activities of the Parks Department, which has been very, very busy in bringing us national recognition and also some new tournaments that will be coming into the area in this coming summer and in the summer of 15 as well. So we appreciate all that the Parks Department does. Thank you very much.
Ms. Hall. Next, we have Public Safety and Judiciary. Honorable Michael Brown, Chairman. Mr. Brown.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. We had two principal items that came before the committee. First, we received information and had a request to take desired action in reference to adjusting the EMS rates to have a realization of the proposed $105,420. The committee recommends the full council board's consideration to adjust the EMS rates. And I so move.
Have a motion. And a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? Vote affirmative. It passes.
Thank you. The second item, the committee received information and had a request to take desired action in reference to a request from the Spartanburg County Emergency Management Department to apply for the Local Emergency Management Performance Grant. The committee recommends the full council that approve the grant application as it will be submitted. I so move.
Second. Have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed? Vote affirmative, and it passes.
That's all the matters that came before the committee. Sure.
Thank you, Mr. Brown. No items under land use. No items under public works. We had one person sign up to speak, but I see she has left the room. If you would come forward, give us your name, please, and address.
Christina Jeffrey, 801 Palmetto Street, okay. Spartanburg. I come representing the Spartanburg Swim Center Action Group. And we want to thank Michael Brown for the interest that he's shown in the swim center. It was run for many years, as you know, as a park. Didn't pay its way, but it provided thousands, many thousands of swimming lessons, a place for children to play in the summer during their holidays when it's hard to find things for kids to do, especially if they have parents who have to work. It's located in a part of town that's accessible pretty much to all parts of the town, centrally located for the county. Some people have complained that the city paid most of the expenses, the county didn't pay anything. 9 out of 10 of the swimmers were from the county. I think this is all irrelevant. What's relevant is a generation of children learned to swim in Spartanburg County because there was an indoor pool available year-round for them to swim in. Now, I'm a Republican, so I believe in the private sector. Probably wouldn't have favored HUD money being used to build that pool in the first place, but it has certainly rendered great service for the expenditure of $1 million in 1980. Today, it costs $4 million to build that pool. There are no plans to build another public pool in Spartanburg. It is the last public pool, as far as I know, in the county. Please correct me if I'm wrong. My request of the county commissioners consider a last-ditch effort to save the swim center. Really, the city has washed its hands of it. It's done with it. Nobody in the city's name is on that building. It has no champions in the city or on the city, in the city governing body, with the exception of Robert Reeder. The district, which owned the pool, said it never really wanted it in the first place. It's just doing a service, allowing the city to get a pool. But it is a valuable asset in this community. And you are the commissioners of Spartanburg County. And when that pool is gone, it will be a loss to this county. It'll be a loss to these citizens. It was a jewel in the city. It is a wonderful pool. And the people who looked at it and wanted to buy it were not even allowed to make a bid. They looked at it the day before against the request of the district. Suddenly, they all of a sudden decided that asbestos abatement had to be done right then. So they never really were, that no business was entertained to acquire an asset that could generate tax revenue in a city that needs tax revenue. And a city that is a part of this county that carries the same name. So I call on you to please prayerfully consider saving the swim center. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Are there any questions?
Nobody answered. Item 7-0 business. Item A, render third reading to an ordinance authorizing the execution and delivery of a fee and lieu tax agreement by and between Spartanburg County and AL Industries Incorporated. And motion.
So moved.
Second. Second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, and it passes. Item B, render third reading to an ordinance authorizing the execution and delivery of a fee and lieu tax agreement between Spartanburg County and IHUS Surface Technology.
So moved.
Correct. Have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, and it passes. Item 3, render third reading to an ordinance to add an uncodified ordinance to the Code of County of Spartanburg to certify Drayton Mill as a textile mill site under South Carolina Textiles Community Revitalization Act.
Second.
Have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, and it passes. Item D, render third reading to an ordinance to add an uncodified ordinance to the Code of Spartanburg to certify Armitage Mill as a textile mill site under the South Carolina Textile Communities Revitalization Act.
So moved.
Have a motion.
Second.
And a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, and it passes. Read the third reading to an unaccompanied ordinance to grant a sanitary sewer easement to Spartanburg Sanitary Sewer District for the Mountain View Sewer Line Extension. Have a motion.
Second.
And a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, it passes. Item F, under second reading to an ordinance authorizing the execution and delivery of a FEMA tax and incentive grant from Spartanburg County and Copac Global Packaging.
So moved.
Have a motion.
Second.
Second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, it passes. Any new business, Captain, to do? Any other resolutions? On the bar amendment, any questions regarding the budget amendment resolutions? If not, we need a motion to pass the budget.
So moved.
Motion. And a second.
Second.
And a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, and it passes. I would like to take just one brief second. I forgot to do this earlier. Mr. Mintz, would you lead us in a happy birthday, Mr. Dale Cook?
Probably more than that, too. We're going to stand up to do it.
I think he needs to stand up.
Yeah, he's not just an odd one, he's getting old.
Yeah, old and ornery.
Oh, yeah.
All right, we're ready?
Yep.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Dale. Happy birthday to you.
Don't worry about this monumental occasion, because I've got a lot of people up here that are actually walking this same road as me. So I hope we get to walk in a long time together.
Sean's birthday, I think, was yesterday. He's celebrating the 10th anniversary of his 50th birthday. And approval of the minutes for October 10 and 21.
I was just going on this miscellaneous thing.
All right, let's go.
This won't take it a second, but Miss Jeffries left before we got to this part. She didn't understand. We can't respond to her comments. But the pool, we all share the value that the pools have in the history of Spartanburg County. Bottom line is, the city just didn't want it. School District 7 just didn't want it. They just couldn't afford it. And when you look at our budget, I mean, if it was something we could do, we could afford to do it. I know all of us would probably fight to have it. But when it comes to the year that we've had, trying to find pennies to make the budget balance, working through our administrator and the Parks and Rec Department, when they can't make it work, we can't make it work. So it's not a matter of we just don't care about it. And I read something that council sat up there in silence. Well, we can't respond when people make public comments at that session. That's their time. It's not a matter of we don't care. We just can't afford it. And that's it.
Thank you, Jim. October, need approval of minutes, October 10 and 21.
So moved.
Second. Motion and second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative. Need a motion to adjourn?
So moved.
Thank you very much for your attendance.